happiness hit her like a train.
Just generally, I'm always working with a relationship to the natural environment, that it's evolved over quite a long time, the ways of dealing with the natural environment. And because I work with both installation out into the urban fabric and into architecture, and I work, you know, with museum installations, and I work, you know, for with gallery work and for private spaces, the work takes many scales and different forms. I address as a very, very particular, most beautiful, most huge and wild and fragile part of Australia called the Kimberley. And I just made the destination up there. I stayed in the Mornington Wildlife Sanctuary that's run by Australian Wildlife Conservation. So I had the knowledge and access and with all the scientists working up there to see what they were doing, to see ways that they were attempting to regenerate land and deal with the problems, and also to help me see what was there. And then I bring these images back to my studio, and I also bring the actual plants back, and I start playing with those images. I sort of paint with them also. I blur areas, I focus much more on certain areas, and I then juxtapose them with pourings of paint. But the paint is actually not paint, it's a medium with the earth I brought back, or sometimes in some cases it's much more of a fluid veil to sort of more diffuse a certain area of the image. I then get the work mounted onto transparent acrylic so that it can then float over another surface, a mirror surface perhaps, or another sort of surface, or even the wall where you just get its shadow cast onto a wall. And then I then layer over it these other layers with the painted layers onto other acrylics. So I'm trying to build up, on the one hand it's planar sculptural work, and on the other hand it's photographic images, but on the other hand it's painted images. So it's just a merging of all of these ways of working together. Run fast for your mother, run fast. I love glass as a material because it's the material that's created visibility. A lot of my glass panels I always sort of thought of as the glass slide that makes visible what is there within the glass. And so these works reference very much kind of herbariums, or the way the botanists start to look at an image under the slide, and the way often in old botanical museums images have been presented to us. Yeah.